Hello everyone, the industry today we talk about the GTW, or means Java Enterprise Editions. So we're going to discuss about the Java Enterprise Editions. It is a large concept. We have n number of topic over there. Okay, in this Java Enterprise Edition we took the web technologies. Using the web technology, how can we can develop a web applications? Okay, so in web technology we use HTML, CSS, JavaScript or CSP and serverless. This languages we use in the web technology in order to develop and web applications. I have some short examples, how to, some short application examples, so I can show you how to develop and web applications in a Eclipse tool. First, we all know all this Eclipse tools we have. Okay, we have separately for a GTW Eclipse tool for separately GTW. Okay, so first we have to create an web application project. So for the going for the file new and dynamic web project. Dynamic web project we have here. So once you click on it, asks for the project name. So I can give my project called demo. So demo is my project name. There is a target for a target run where this server is there. I have a version called 3.0 and then okay. The next, if you go on further, it will have a source folder where we have Java files will be here, and the class folder we have here, class file will be saved. So here we have a check mark called generate a web.xml document description. So if you wanted web.xml, we can have a development. So if you give the finish, it will create a dynamic web project in Eclipse. So we can get it in our project folder. So here nothing but means we have an arrangement of folder, so we have to put it this kind of code in this folder so that the Apache Tomcat, where the server software will take the coding from specified locations. So here the source folder will be available where your Java folder or serverless program or the program can be stored here, and the web content where we can store our HTML, CSS, JavaScript and image files will be stored in here, and as well as the JSP page also. First, I'm going to create an HTML page. So, in the web content, I'm going to right click on new and then going for an HTML file here. So, you want to create an HTML file here. I give the index name of the index, I give any name. So, I give the index.html. I give the finished here, and then we are getting the HTML code here. So, here, what I do now, I'm going to have an input box and a button. So if I type the input box and press the button, it's called the servlets. The data can be moved to the server side using help of post method. Okay, so first we have got a form tag over here. So in the form I given a action, given action over here. So action equal to, okay, so action equal to me need to server. So okay, so I'm here to the input type ev equal to text. Okay, so here text is available. So I can close this simple tag. I'm just closing this tag, and then I have a button. Okay, I have to wait, that's also input type submit. So I have to give the value for the button, so they need to display. So value will be the just out of what the text should be in the button. I give the sent. Okay, so if you give the submit only, it will submit the server, or else it will not be getting the server. Okay, this name should be mapped with the servlets program. So how can you create a servlets program? It's most simple. I already told Java file, servlets also one of the Java file. So you can create it in the source folder. So source, right click on new and go on for the servlets. So here my package is then give the form package, and here the class name will be the server. So I just finish it. So now here I create the servlets. Okay, so now I create the servlets. Okay, this is open version. So I have to map that Apache Tomcat here. So I go in for the build configurations. Okay, so I want library files here. I want class. Sorry, so add a library here. Library, we have a server runtime here. So go for the next. So I don't have a server over here, so I will click it and then go for the server. Okay, I have to add the new server here. I have a HTTP already, we have this, so no into HTTP. I have an Apache Tomcat 6 is available here. 6, I think someone is available here. I think someone I'm available here. So for the next, if you go, either you can install, or if you have map with your what you already installed, you know, you can map with that. So I'm a program files Apache Tomcat 7 I'm available, so I can go for OK and finish. So now I have to runtime. So run, make a build path here. So library and add a library over. So it's the runtime. So I select an Apache Tomcat 7 here and just finish it. So now give me OK. Now your application is mapped with the Apache Tomcat. So now error will be filled because the Apache Tomcat will have the servlet-api key. Okay. So now Apache is ready with the servlet's name. Okay. So this name and this name should be common. So the case sensitive S is smaller than that. So you can use S is capital. Yes. And save it. And now I can run the application. So right click. So before I running the applications, I want to know that this is going to be done with the common going to get method. Okay, so before going for run method, I'm going to string. Okay, I'm going to get a method in string. String data. So request dot get parameter. So this is a object with method. I'm just getting data. That's a simple data. Sorry, I'm able to give the name here. Name should be to specify the name. Name equal to message. So I'm going to convey the message here. So how the message will be? Message equal to what we entered. The data will be more traveled to the server. So here I give the get parameter using the message. So I just entered here. So name is given. So I will get the unstored it in the data variables. Okay, I can print it out here also. So data. So I can print it here. The server at the data of this I can print it, and then have some space over here. Okay, so space over there. So if I run the applications, so if I enter the data, the next page will provide the data watch by enter. Okay, so server on run, run on server. Okay, if I run it. The application will run it and it will open on the browser. So default browser I'm having there. Okay, so here I'm having the default browser. If I enter the hi to the file item, hi to the file item, I'll just write in there. And if I send it, data will be sent it like message hi to the file item. So server at hi to the file item slash demo, the project name is displayed in the next pages. So this is a simple example for web application where you can develop the complete web application. So if you have some components, additional components will be there. We will see on the next tutorial. Thank you for watching this video.